Hello, I'm Dr. Andrew Neville, and I want to talk to you about one of the more concerning issues that not only do I have, but the CDC and the NIH has as well, is the overuse of antibiotics in our society today, right? Antibiotics are commonplace, I mean, discovered a long time ago, and are absolutely life-saving and essential for treatment of severe or significant bacterial infection, life-saving. So I'm not against antibiotics. But you may even notice if you go into your general practitioner that the CDC is coming out saying you should not over-prescribe antibiotics, especially if somebody has a virus, which if we look at like an upper respiratory infection, you know, probably 90%+ of those are viral and not bacterial. Now, antivirals, they're harder, right? They're harder on the body. They kill the cells, whereas antibiotics you can use very specifically. So bacteria are very different than viruses, just structurally. Thing is, a lot of these conditions, right, a lot of viruses, a lot of things that we deal with, especially all the respiratory stuff, it's not bacterial, right? It's really a viral problem. And using antibiotics to treat a virus will do nothing to treat the virus. They'll talk about, you know, suppressing a secondary bacterial infection that you might get or whatever. And then there's this idea that, well, what about the mucus? Is the mucus clear or yellow or green? And you can get green mucus with a virus, right? That doesn't automatically mean that you have a bacterial infection that you have to jump to antibiotics. Most of the time, we can use natural antimicrobials, right, which is this broad term, to talk about, it kills a broad variety of germs, microbes, bacteria, viruses, yeast, parasites, things like that, right? So there are a variety of natural antimicrobials that you can use that don't give you the associated kind of side effects and adverse reactions that you can have with, you know, harder, stronger antibiotics. Things like berberine is probably one of my favorites that comes in a few different plants, but berberine is a direct kind of an antimicrobial that has kind of broad spectrum against bacteria, viruses, and a few different others. Garlic is even another one that has kind of broad spectrum antibiotic activity, even towards C. difficile, right? Which is this, that's a certain form of antibiotic-associated diarrhea, not crazy common, but definitely causes some more severe reaction, but plenty of research on garlic and treating that. In fact, curcumin coming from turmeric is another one that's effective against C. difficile, but other viruses, bacteria, especially things that hit the mucous membrane. So gut reactions as well as upper respiratory types of reactions. So there are numerous natural antibiotics or antimicrobials. And one of my favorites to use internally, to use topically, colloidal silver. Colloidal silver is a wonderful tool that is broad spectrum antimicrobial. It's not necessarily an immune support like some people talk about. I just think of it as an antimicrobial. It's an antibiotic. Take it while you have the infection and then don't take it. And that's how I recommend taking most of these things, is kind of like you would take an antibiotic. Take it for a series of time, right? Maybe that's a week, 2 weeks. And then when you're not infected anymore, you don't have symptoms, then don't take it and just put it on the shelf and take it next time. So there are a ton of different things in our kind of natural armamentarium, and there are way more than I just described. Trying to tease out and look into the various research on, well, what about oregano oil? What about olive? Yes, definitely. But certain ones have been tested for certain bugs. Oregano is a good one, actually, that I like quite a bit. Even caprylic acid, which comes in coconut oil, is great, especially from an anti-yeast perspective. So there are a lot of things in the natural world that can act as antimicrobials that can assist us, that are safe to take conservatively prior to, say, going to a harder core antibiotic or even an antiviral or something like that. And I'm not against using that. I'm against overusing those things. Most of the time, we support the immune system. You know, you eat right, you slow down, and maybe take some natural antimicrobial, and usually you can get through that infection just fine without needing something stronger, which can then mess with a bunch of other things and cause dysbiosis and problems down the line. So plenty of natural ways to get after bacterial, viral infections, things like that, to be experimented with. All my best.